This is the 18th annual. So we started this tournament 18 years ago, right here at Legacy Country Club. And here we are almost two decades later, and it has grown. It's gotten bigger, better, raises more money for Manatee Public Schools. And I just couldn't be more happy with how it's worked out. It's so important. You know, there's really nothing good or bad in society that can't be linked back to education or the lack thereof. And when we're able to supplement our education dollars, and remember, the money we raise here, the dollars that go into public schools go places where tax dollars cannot go. And so what you end up having is opportunities for students that they otherwise would not have had. Teachers reach out and ask for mini grants, whether it's for supplies for science or to take a trip to Washington for Odyssey of the Mind. Whatever it is, it's something that they wouldn't have been able to do but for the dollars that are raised at this event. I do chair the Appropriations Committee on Education. That covers everything from pre-K, K through 12, our technical schools, our college system, and our universities. And so I'm working with it every day. And to be able to step out of my political life and into a community life and supplement what we do by raising dollars for our classrooms. My father was a golf pro, but way more than that, he was a real innovator. He was one of the first real celebrity golf instructors. He had the first syndicated golf television show, actually wrote two bestsellers on the subject, and was world-renowned for some of his pupils back in the day, from Bob Hope to Carol Burnett to Joey Bishop, Tony Bennett, Vic Damone, Perry Como. And so, and he lived in this area, but I can tell you his passion was young people and opportunities for young people. And he valued so much education. He used to tell me, he'd say, if you go to bed at night and you can't think of anything you've learned during the day, then you've wasted your day. And for him to have a legacy of helping young people learn and supplementing and supplying opportunities in education, that would have meant the world to him. And I'm sure he's watching now and smiling. What I want the community to know is that there is nothing more important than education. Education is a gateway, an opportunity. It can change the nature of society and make us productive, bring about prosperity, bring about creativity. There's so much that education contributes to. And I would like the community to realize that you can never do enough for education. Naturally, we have funding at the local and the state level and even some at the federal level, but that shouldn't be where it ends. We as citizens need to recognize the value of education and when we can, participate in its promotion. Oh yeah, so Representative Boyd's here, Representative Nelson, Representative Moskowitz. We've got Democratic leader Chris Smith is here, Senator Joe Negron, Senator Anna Terry Flores, Senator Aaron Bean, Senator Jeff Brandis. So we could almost hold session out on the course today, but we won't. We understand the sunshine laws. So, well, we're very proud, and we're just a part of a much larger team, including METV, who's out here year after year, making sure more and more people know about what we're doing here and what the foundation is doing. And so, you know, no one person can take credit for it, but I'm so pleased that it's named for my father.
I got to tell you, what the Galvano family has done for this event and what they do for the Education Foundation is just fantastic. It really, truly is. And we really have a debt of gratitude to the entire Galvano family for what they do. The amount of money that we raise at this event right here, I think I've maybe missed one or two in all the years that they've done it. When you look at that extra money and the books and the process and helping the teachers and helping us supplies, it's just fantastic. And it doesn't come out of the taxpayer's money. And so it's really a great deal. And it's a great event. It's a lot of fun event. But more importantly, what we can do for the kids is fantastic. If we want our kids to stay here when they graduate from high school and colleges, we have to have good jobs. We cannot attract good jobs without an educated workforce. And so it kind of grows on itself. The more educated workforce you have, we attract more industry. More industry gives more jobs to our kids coming here. And if we want these kids to have a leg up in the world, it's so important that in order to compete internationally, around the globe, okay, Manatee and Sarasota County have got to raise the best. And that's what we're trying to do. My four son is my wife, my gorgeous wife, so we've got the handicap right there. She's ready. And then we're playing with the Verizon team. They've been kind enough to invite me. But I still wrote a personal check to the Education Foundation.
Well, what a great way to do it. We get to have fun and we get to raise lots of money for the kids, all thanks to Senator Bill Galvano. They do fill the gaps for things that education can't afford or doesn't have the time to do. I'm sure he pays for field trips. He pays for a lot of things that are listed as special, but those special things are the things that keep kids coming to school and keep them involved. So he provides a wonderful service for the community. Well, when we have extra money, we put it where it's most needed. We fill holes, and education is where we've always wanted to put our money. And we did that K through 20. The universities benefited, all education partners benefited this year. I think it's great, and if you look at what a beautiful day it is, it's just paradise living here. We work so hard in Tallahassee, and then to come home and to be able to enjoy a day like this for a good cause, it's just a win-win. I am playing with my golf partner from Venice and a couple of lobbyists who are big contributors to this event from Tallahassee. My tip is I hope they all drink a lot of beer, and I won't, and I'll be the winner. We're all competitive.
Well, a fabulous day takes fabulous food, and that's what we're all about out here today. The perfect finger food for golfers. We got these fabulous organic all beef grass-fed sliders that are delicious. Tommy is my name. I am from Buffalo, so we got Tommy's I am from Buffalo wings out there. You know, all the fun things that you want, fresh grouper tacos that we're making, some real delicious, fun, simple finger foods. Well, we're part of this community, and we want to see the next generation be as successful as possible and have the same opportunities that we had growing up, and we want them to grow into productive parts of this wonderful place we live.
You know, we've been out here at this event all since the very, very beginning of it. We're proud to be part of the Education Foundation for Manatee County. It's just amazing what the Galvano family has done for our community and for the education in Manatee County. We're really proud to be part of it. Well, it just shows you how wonderful our community is, because you've got everybody here. Just like you said, you've got politicians, you've got paupers, you've got everybody. It's a great day to be out here. The superintendent just walked by, you've got state senators. You've got everybody that's anybody in Manatee County is right out here. So we bring the whole region together, and it's all for the education. There's no question. Yeah, the Pace Center for Girls is having their fundraiser. Tonight is the cocktail party. Tomorrow's the duck race on the Manatee River. Amanda is chairman of the board of directors for Pace Center for Girls, and it's part of the school system. It's part of the education system. Wonderful, wonderful program that helps girls in Manatee County. So I'm real proud of Amanda for doing that. We are. I mean, everybody gets hungry, everybody gets thirsty while you're playing golf. You might as well have one of the award-winning margaritas from the Oyster Bar. And, you know, you might as well eat too. So we brought food and drink for everybody out here today. It's the basis for our community. I mean, we need to educate our young people. If you don't start early with a good education system, you're behind the eight ball. And we're real pleased with the direction that the school board and the new superintendent, we're just pleased with the direction the education system's moving in Manatee County. And we're just really happy to be here so that we can do our part to help.
Well, everything that this Galvano Foundation does is good work. I mean, the kids that they're educating through this foundation, it's right up our alley, stuff that we like to do on a daily basis. It's part of the community, makes the community thrive, and then our businesses all thrive too. Education is the key to making this community thrive. Well, I've always had a saying, if you build your community, you're gonna build your own business. The people that are associated with this foundation and the people that are beneficiaries of it, they appreciate it. And if you're a sponsor of an organization like this, like I am, the consumer rewards you with purchasing your product, like our fine Bud Light products all over Manatee and Sarasota County. I'll tell you, that was an emotional night for me, the Daughters of the American Revolution. I told them, I said, hey, I'm just an Italian kid from the west side of Detroit. When the Daughters of the American Revolution were founded, my ancestors were stomping grapes in Italy, but I appreciate them recognizing my military contributions in my 32-year Marine Corps career, and then my contributions to the veterans that we do here with my company by hiring them. We hire all those vets. They make great employees, and I would advise every employer out there to take a close look at these vets because they make things happen in your business.
Well, first of all, Bill Galvano is a great friend and a great guy. He's done so much for education in Manatee County in a lot of ways. And this tournament just demonstrates his commitment to that. Raises a lot of money for a great cause, and I'm thrilled to be here. It's a beautiful day outside, lots of people here, and we're going to have a lot of fun. But it's a great event for a great cause. Yeah, I mean, among local projects, hopefully, that are being funded, it's the most money Florida will ever spend on education in its history. So I'm very excited about that. I think it's the right thing to do for the right reason. So I'm glad to be a small part of that. I think it just demonstrates everybody's broad support for such a great cause. Education is vitally important to Florida, vitally important to our future, and I think it just demonstrates everybody cares about it, everybody's working hard to support it. I got a great foursome. I got my legislative aide, I got my son Austin, and my friend Chairman Brian Nelson, who's the representative from Apopka. I got a tip for Senator Mike Bennett, take up tennis.
It's important because we have an opportunity to support the initiatives that the school board has put out for the school system. And the dollars that we raise from both of our community leaders, our business leaders, go directly into the classroom to support our students and the teachers. So we have a great opportunity. We're excited about the initiatives that the school has, and we want to continue to support that. We've got a fantastic board, and I'll let these ladies kind of talk about that as well.
Yes, it does. And I can honestly say, Charles, I've been on the foundation now for more than about 20 years when Marge Canaan first began the foundation. And it has grown tremendously from probably raising $5,000 to now currently, I believe we have over $250,000, $300,000. And Ross is right. It has grown from just a few community members to now the whole state of Florida, and not just the state of Florida.
I want the community to know that the Education Foundation is very important in supporting our Manatee County school students. And I'm one of the newer members of the board. So we've got one of the oldest members of the board and one of the newer members of the board and longest standing members of the board, I should say. And we're just really proud to support the Education Foundation and be able to help the district with special programs that they need.
I have one more thing to say. Samantha represents Folly Bryant. Folly Bryant has supported us. As you know, Rick Folly is on the board, and they have supported us through every endeavor we have gone through in raising funds for our students in Manatee County.